What mustn't you feed hedgehogs?
Bread and milk.
Exactly. Bread and milk is a bad idea. People do it. It gives them diarrhoea and they dry out.
You really feed bread and milk to any mammal, including humans.
But there is a Radio 4 show that
deals... come off it. No, well, you shouldn't feed humans bread and milk.
No, not really.
What do you mean, not really? It's absolutely demonstrably fine.
No, it's not very good for you.
Well, it's fine.
Bread and butter.
We've been drinking milk and eating bread for ages. Why is it suddenly a massive problem? Oh, yeah. No, actually, we're supposed to live till we're 250. But no, we've been eating all this poisonous bread and milk all the time. We barely live past 98. It's ridiculous. Of course we're supposed to eat bread and milk. Not just bread and milk.
Oh, poor Alan.
No,
don't bully him. Poor Alan.
It's not...
You shake hands and be friends.
Sorry,
now.
Alan.
Yeah. Don't clean a teapot.
You don't clean a teapot,
you should never
David.
Clean a teapot.
No.
Under no circumstance.
Not under no circumstance.
No, well,
if it's
okay,
being used as a teapot...
If you well, came no. in and couldn't find the loo one night...
I have only...
Call a hunch, but I sense a hypothetical situation.
This is not a hypothetical situation. I've only ever used a teapot for tea. But occasionally, if you make sort of tea in a teapot once in a blue moon when you can be bothered in a vague attempt to seem more civilised than you actually are, you then sort of leave, still got a bit of tea in
you
it.
Left
some
it
tea
oh, yeah, you rinse
you leave
it out.
It. No, you don't rinse it out because
it
you forget because immediately you're tired of being civilised and you want to go to the pub. You leave it for weeks and weeks and months and months, and then when you have a look in it, it's gone disgustingly mouldy.
And it's talking to you.
Yeah.
At that point, the flavour that you would get if you didn't wash it from your next cup of tea is, if anything, too characterful. The thing that seems unfair to me is the number of people who are expected to pretend they care about jobs they don't care about. Mm. You should be allowed to say, look, I'm fulfilling my contract. You can't put in the contract, also you have to seem like you give a shit. I think that's expecting too much.
Yeah.
That's why I really like the fact that we live in a country with such poor customer service. I've got respect for that. You know, this is a horrible train, you're tearing tickets. Of course you're in an awful mood.
I don't know, now that you've put it like that, I shall feel better about it.
You're right.
Why have a cheesy grin on your face if you are working in an awful supermarket?
Well, it's the sign either of a liar or a moron.
Yeah.
You know when you find a bee and it's crawling on its last legs?
I always rescue them.
You give it honey. The only thing they eat. Makes sense when you think about it.
Isn't it true, though, that a bee in his entire lifetime makes an absolutely tiny amount of honey overall? I mean, just a
but
minute
just lots
amount
of them.
Of honey.
Yeah, but they're
so you don't have to give much rehabilitating honey to this one bee so before the nation, the world, is making a net loss. I mean, it's useless. If you only get one teaspoon of honey from a whole bee's lifetime and every time we have to get it back on its feet, it takes a teaspoon and a half, suddenly there's no honey at all.
This is more honey than this bee has seen in its life.
Yeah. You're insulting it, apart from anything else. It's like showing a very tired mason a whole cathedral.
Very interesting and surprising, because almost everybody thinks that vertical stripes make people look slimmer. In fact, in prisons, sometimes women have asked for vertical rather than horizontal stripes so that they look leaner, or they think they'll look leaner. But it turns out research from a man called Dr. Peter Thompson of York University has discovered that the large majority think the one in the vertical stripe is larger than the one in the horizontal stripe when they are the same size.
Surely this shows, actually, that it makes no real difference at all. Because what this, we're determining whether wearing vertical or horizontal stripes makes you look thinner.
Yeah.
And you can't tell by looking. You have to do research. The difference is so slight, you have to do research with hundreds and hundreds of people. Basically, people look as fat or thin as they are.
I beg to differ.
I have a friend who's quite short and he likes to wear vertical stripes because they make him look taller.
Only when he's not standing next to anyone. It's not going to make him look taller than a taller man. It's all relative. He'll just say, well, there's a normal-sized man next to an enormous man. And then you go, oh, thank my God, he's taking his striped shirt off. It's actually a tiny man next to a normal man.
I've missed your angry logic, David, I have to say.
I think it just alternates, doesn't it? For ages, you think, OK, vertical stripes make people look thinner. Then you say, oh, she's wearing vertical stripes, therefore she must be fatter than she looks. Therefore, you start thinking, oh, she looks fatter because she's wearing vertical stripes. So suddenly, horizontal stripes start making you look thinner because, oh, she must be thin, otherwise she'd never dare wear horizontal stripes. Then they go, oh, no, horizontal stripes make you look thinner. Oh, she must be fat, she's wearing horizontal stripes.
What would you use one of these for?
What would I use it for, or what is it meant for?
Oh, isn't this for fish? Getting things out of fish.
Ah, interesting thought.
On the Swiss Army knife, there's one for scooping out a fish eye.
They're not as difficult to get out, the eye of a fish, are they? They're pretty squidgy, unless the fish is still alive. Fish don't blink, which is the main eye defence.
This.
If you're ever trying to get the eye out of a fish and it blinks, it may be a lion.
Which is correct of these grocers? It's grocers apostrophe.
One of the requirements of being a sign printing company is having a basic knowledge of where an apostrophe goes.
They know, I'm convinced. All sign writing companies know, for example, how to spell accommodation. They must. And I reckon when they say, OK, we're doing a sign for your guest house, would you like our normal service or would you like our deluxe gold 5x the price service? Well, we'll check your spelling for you. And everyone goes, no, it's all right, I'm not going to pay 5x as much for you to check the spelling. They go, OK. Inevitably, OK, we're gonna paint the word accommodation the way you've put it there, are we? In the knowledge that they'll have to get called back all the sooner when the people finally realise they've got it wrong. It's just every time you see accommodation properly painted and misspelt, the sign writer knew. Bloody mind me putting it out there wrong, knowing you'd get a repeat gig all
you
the
sooner. See how long it's been looking for a flat,
huh? When was the First World War first named as such?
The outbreak, the assassination of Archduke Ferdinand.
You think they called it the First World War straight
before
away?
Before it started.
It would be an act of a pessimist to call it the First World War that early, surely. It's going to be some point after 1939, isn't it?
A realist, surely. So it's right. Going to be more of these. Yeah.
At what point... Excuse me, I think what I said, people in the box, is after 1939, yes. Which may contain 1939, but does not mean it.
No, well...
Okay. No. After 1939 and after the Second World War are not synonymous. Now, this is just giving you time to type. After 1939. Why don't you just type, Mitchell is a cop?
Well, I wouldn't put it past them. And finally, how many brains did the man with two brains have?
Two.
Yes. That's brilliant. Yeah, he's wise enough to spot a double bluff.
It's just the technique of the bully. You hit us. And then you go, oh, what do you think I was going to hit you? I'm not going to hit you. Oh, I'm just as my hand to stroke you. And we're here,
That's exactly what we do.